Good afternoon, fellow iStaters. This is Paul Gordon of iState.tv, and this is your daily dose of headlines you may have missed for Tuesday, February 14th, 2018. This is episode 27. Give us 20 minutes, and we'll give you headlines that aren't dominated with fear porn. We'll give you headlines of awareness, hope, action, and yeah, maybe just a little bit of lulls. And if you're watching this on YouTube, you miss the opening of the show, and you'll also miss the very end, which you can only hear if you watch live on my personal Facebook page, Paul Gordon. The image of the profile matches the image on this show. So today's show title is, and you can see the image there, It's Not Stealing When It's Civil Asset Forfeiture. And you can get the show notes at isheadlines.com or check out the links to the show notes page in the description for both Facebook and also the YouTube video. Or you could go to iState.tv/H027, and you can also find our audio podcast show on iTunes by searching for iState. You'll see I have a little hesitation here because I screwed something up, man. I was messing with some stuff, and I screwed something up. Oh, well, I'll fix it for the next show. Be that as it may, on today's episode of Headlines You May Have Missed, civil asset whining, ghost gun fear mongering, Facebook adpocalypse, and more. And now, ladies and gentlemen, here are your headlines you may have missed. Colorado bill seeks to, quote, fix, unquote, civil asset forfeiture law after cops complain about lost revenue. And this is where we get our story from. Remember, folks, as I go over this story, remember, it's not stealing if it's civil asset forfeiture. So after Colorado attempted to rein back the abuse of police departments by limiting how they could use civil asset forfeiture, pushbacks came from the police departments. And by the way, it's more than the police departments. It would be the thin blue liners that support the police departments, lockstep, no questions asked. So it would be a combination of the police departments and the thin blue liners that support them, lockstep, no question asked, who complained that the loss of civil asset forfeiture was a loss of revenue for the departments. Now remember, civil asset forfeiture, it's ostensibly to prevent criminals from doing bad things with their assets while they're going through the process of being adjudicating. Remember that. But the complaint isn't that the criminals are getting away from stuff. The complaint is, we're losing our revenues. That's right. They were complaining about the lost funds. But remember, civil asset forfeiture is not theft. So just as a refresher, I'm gonna drill this home. Let me remind you that civil asset forfeiture is the process of stealing money and material from individuals who are merely suspected, not found guilty, suspected of using money and material in the commission of a crime or in the possession of the individual as a result of a crime. You don't need to prove it. The cop just says, you know what? You probably committed a crime. I'll take that. Good luck getting it back, by the way. Just a little friendly reminder. Civil asset forfeiture claimed more revenue for police departments nationwide than all of the burglaries did for burglars nationwide. They out-burglared the burglars. But remember, it's not theft. It's not stealing if it's civil asset forfeiture, even though it is a multi-billion dollar racket, and it has become the mother's milk for a number of police departments. But Let's just gloss over that. And so the story is from GCSentinel.com. apparently Leslie Herod had no trouble getting her bill addressing civil asset forfeiture out of a House committee Monday, and this is a Colorado House committee. The Denver Democrat got a bill through last year's session restricting how local law enforcement agencies could pursue civil asset forfeiture. Well, we heard a lot. This is the whiner. Well, the whiner enabler talking, Herod. We heard a lot from local law enforcement agencies, specifically Mesa County, who were saying that they would lose funds if they were required to go through the state process. Oh, poor guys. So this is a make whole fund. If they can prove that they are getting less funds this year than they were last year, they get to apply. So what they're going to do is they're going to make sure that if you're not getting the amount of booty that you were before, then they'll go ahead and send you some booty gotten from another source. It's kind of like you show up at a thief's house every Friday with a new TV so that the thief doesn't go out and steal another TV. Law enforcement work with media to drum up fears of ghost guns. And more and more, I'm really interested. I'm tracking this whole ghost gun narrative very, very carefully. By the way, I refer to these quote-unquote ghost guns as liberty guns. They're liberty guns, okay? They are guns. They are tools of self-defense that are created by individuals outside the prying eyes of the coercive enterprise. Yes, they're liberty guns. So the thin blue line is joining in with the Prague state media to attempt to rile up fear among the non-gov, non-shiny badge folks in an effort to trigger these non-gov, non-shiny badge. Boy, that's a hard sentence to say. That's a hard phrase. Non-shiny badge folks. And I say it a number of times in this article, so I should try to get it down. What they're trying to do is they're trying to essentially get the non-shiny badge folks to not only beg, but demand that the shiny badge folks, or the folks that enable the shiny badge folks, the government folks, that they go ahead and they take away the individual's ability to, well, they can't take away their ability to build their own tools of self-defense, but to criminalize it, to put them at risk of, let's just say, a fine, kidnapping, or worst case scenario, death, assassination, if you will. Not strictly speaking, but yeah, they're going to kill you if you continue to resist. So it eventually leads to that if you continue to resist. So I'm highlighting here Boston 25. And I'm not going to get into everything in this article. I definitely encourage you to check this article out in the show notes, which are linked in Facebook, YouTube descriptions. I'm going to highlight who is behind this article. The article doesn't have any name on it. It's an investigative report by Boston 25. And it basically carries a narrative. It's so scary. You know, we went out and we could build a ghost gun all by ourselves, and we realized this is totally untraceable. And then they get a quote from some ATF dude that's like, yes, this is very scary, you know, terrorists and stuff. You know, you guys can fill in the dots there. So the company, or the media outlet, the new local news outlet, is owned by Cox Media Group, which is a subdivision of Cox Enterprises, Inc., which is owned by the Cox family. The current chairman is James C. Kennedy, who happens to be the son-in-law or son now, I can't remember. But anyway, he's connected to the mother, who is the daughter of the father of the, I don't know. It's the generational possession of Cox Enterprises, Inc. So I am not sure if James is aware that a news outlet owned by his family is now actively pursuing agitprop of the rising police state in the form of anti-liberty gun propaganda. But If he is, then he's complicit in their pro-police state work. And if he's not, perhaps people should attempt to bring this to his attention. Does he really want the Cox family name associated with this kind of fake news, anti-liberty, police state propaganda? See, the tactic here, by the way, is hold people personally accountable. Individuals. James C. Kennedy, I am putting your name out there to be held personally accountable for this agitprop police state garbage that a news outlet owned by your company is putting out. Russia tells YouTube, remove video or be blocked. And this is a great kind of sobering reminder. I know that a lot of folks kind of cheer Putin on, especially if they're kind of right-leaning folks, because Putin, well, he's a master troll of the left. And in a lot of ways, I said this a long time ago, I said, you know, the Obama mystique was broken by Putin. He was the first person who not only effectively stood up to Obama, but he actually beat him. He clearly outfought him. He totally destroyed Obama on the world stage. But let's remember who Putin is. This story reminds us of who Putin is. He's no darling of liberty. So somebody puts a YouTube video up on I don't even care what it's about, but I think it's connected to Trump, but it doesn't matter. What matters is that Putin and Russia are saying, YouTube, take that video down or we're going to block you from being in Russia anymore. Of course, that assumes that suddenly Russians are not going to have access to VPNs. I mean, Russia? VPN? Hello? Really, anybody who has a website that tracks anything will know how much traffic comes to their site, spam traffic, I'll say, that comes from their website from Russian VPNs. So I don't know if it'll work, but regardless, they're trying it. So this is Putin. He believes if YouTube has a video that he doesn't like, that he should just cut it off for everyone in Russia. That's who you're dealing with, folks. Keep that in mind the next time you want to cheer Putin on. Is Adpocalypse coming to Facebook? And if so, why should you care? This is actually our top story on iState.tv today, but it's not our top feature in headlines you may have missed. Long story behind what I pick for the top headlines for headlines you may have missed, which I won't get into right now. It is the top story today on iState.tv. The iLiberty category, by the way, is our top story category. So it looks like Facebook may be facing the same type of social justice enforcement through corporate power backlash that YouTube went through. First, Unilever threatened Facebook to become more social justice certified, and now Salesforce is making similar demands on Facebook. And it's the Salesforce.com Inc. Chief Executive Officer, Mark, I hate freedom and I will use all of my power to crush it, Benioff said. This is the essential quote. You're going to see the beginning of a movement. When these crises hit, it's like a tidal wave. He said his company won't invest in platforms or environments that do not protect our children or which create divisions in society. I wonder what he would classify as divisions. I would be willing to bet divisions are anything that deviates from the state-on-state phase progressive script. And I am always, by the way, careful to point out when I say progressive, I'm specifically going after the state-on-state phase progressives, because not all progressives are state-on-state phase. But maybe that's a discussion on one of our iSDaily shows. Earn cryptos by performing AI tasks with your smartphone. Let me tell you about D-Brain, and it's a blockchain application that enables people to use their smartphones to perform AI-related tasks that will then earn them cryptocurrency. So the application is especially promising in creating earning opportunities for people in low-income countries. This is from Cointelegraph.com. So the company points out that 80% of AI developments is data-related, and labeling and maintaining these data sets requires a lot of human effort. By creating this platform, D-Brain says they can enable those in lower-income countries to take a share of the booming AI industry, rewarding workers with D-Brain coins for their efforts. Workers can label as much or as little as they choose and can cash in their coins for U.S. dollars whenever they would like. Now that's the kind of innovation I personally applaud. 100 or more Russian fighters killed by U.S. troops in Syria battle. This definitely bears paying attention to, folks. A battle took place at a U.S. base in Syria last week that turns out to have been between American troops on one side and fighters working for a private company on the other side. These fighters happen to be from Russia and the Ukraine. So in Syria last week, American fighters did battle with Russian and Ukrainian fighters. After the dust settled, the numbers are, as you can expect, conflicting. The U.S. is claiming that 100 Russian fighters were killed during the failed assault on the U.S. base. I think I've seen somewhere the Russians are claiming 200. And the Americans are saying, no, it's only 100, 200 or 300 injured. Dig deeper for new antibiotics, literally in the dirt. So we're running out of sources for antibiotics to keep fighting the next round of flus. But one microbiologist thinks he knows a whole feckin' bed of sources for the next and the next and the next set of antibiotics. That source is literally dirt. And this is from the Washington Post. In labs around the world, scientists are racing against time to cultivate new microbe-destroying molecules. But most of the low-hanging fruit has already been picked. So microbiologist Sean Bradley thinks it's time to shift tactics. Instead of growing antibiotics in a petri dish, he hopes to find them in the ground. Every place you step, there's 10,000 bacteria, most of which we've never seen, said Brady, an associate professor at Rockefeller University in New York. Many of these bacteria behave in ways that aren't yet understood and produce molecules that haven't been seen before. So there you go. If you want to get rid of the bug, you got to get dirty. Biovia CEO becomes guinea pig of youth restoring gene therapy. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, this is your moment of lulls. So the CEO of a company that is working on reversing the aging process through gene therapy has become the guinea pig, of her own company. The initial results suggest that the company Biovia makes more sense, may be onto something, and that's good news for those of us over the age of 30. That's not me, because, by the way, ladies and gentlemen, I don't know if I've ever told you this before, but if you ask me my age, I will scoff at you. I will look down upon my nose at you. I may even bite my thumb at you. I could do that, and I will say to you, you are limited in your chronological blind spots. You are so pedestrian in your thinking, for I exist outside of chronology. I am youth. But for those of you still limited by chronology that are over the age of 30, this could be good news for you. And yes, I did clap for myself there. And this is from sanvada.com. Biovia, a U.S.-based biotech company that specializes in licensing gene therapies set to cure aging ailments, used the procedure on CEO Elizabeth Parrish. This makes her the, quote, first, unquote, person to have reconfigured the blood cells to stop aging. Current therapeutics offer only marginal benefits for people suffering from diseases of aging. Aging is the ultimate disease, isn't it? Additionally, lifestyle modification has limited impact on treating these diseases. Advances in biotechnology are the best solution. And if these results are anywhere near accurate, we've made history, commented Parrish. Aging is a DNA, According to Parrish, the gene therapy has enhanced the lifespan of the telomere by a whopping 20 years. This was after she received two experimental, one containing muscle mass and the other with longevity gene, therapies back in 2015, then 44 years of age. To confirm this, scientists at SpectraCell tested Elizabeth's white blood cells, and it was noted that the telemeter had lengthened from 6.71 kb to 7.33 kb. This meant that the health of the cells was lengthened 20 more times. Holy papuli. That's excellent news. I'm getting in line. Not that I need to, but just to humor you guys, I will get in line, even though I am youth and I exist outside of chronology. Greece files demarche against Turk Reich Rams patrol after Turk Reich Rams patrol vessel in the Aegean. Yeah, you got to be paying attention to the Turk Reich folks, because I'm telling you, they're rattling sabers and they're invoking the ghost of the Ottoman Empire. Not good. Not good at all. Greece may be running out of patience with the Turk Reich as they continue to aggressively badger and now even ram ships in the Aegean as they make a bid to claim waters that are not theirs. The push to claim waters that do not belong to the Turk Reich is centered around the oil and gas under those waters. Erdogan needs fuel for the military machine he is building, a machine he hopes will recreate the Ottoman Empire. And the Greeks have fired a demarche with the Turkish embassy in Athens, which is essentially a formal diplomatic protest. The demarche was filed after the Turks rammed a Greek Coast Guard patrol vessel last week. Our last story. New York prepares for new round of anti-gun bills. The anti-gunners of New York State are at it again with a round of anti-gun bills that target 3D printed guns, prohibit people guilty of committing hate crimes from having guns, and adding the time it takes to go through a background check. These New York grabbers will do whatever they can do to further disarm and undermine the ability of people without magic badges to be able to effectively defend themselves. And this is from Legislative Gazette. So, you know what? That's it. We're out of that time. So I'll just real quick, just a couple headlines that we didn't get to. 3D printing complex nanoscale metal structures might be new frontier. Self-driving drones are here, literally now. Philadelphia's DA offices keep secret list of suspect police. Scientific breakthrough could be as simple as measuring the wobble of a muon. And if you've heard the beeps, I think you know all too well what that means. That means that's all we have today for headlines you may have missed. And if you'd like to read more about the stories we covered today, just go to isheadlines.com and find the show notes for February 14th, 2018. Or check out the link to the show notes page in the description for both the Facebook live stream and YouTube video, or go to iState.tv/H027. And you can also find our audio podcast show on iTunes by searching for iState and the audio podcast version of this show. It only has headlines, just the 20-minute timer part. That's it. That's all the audio podcast consists of. And don't forget to join me tonight on iSDaily Wednesday with the One True Niz at 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on the Liberty Principle Facebook page with the link included in the description. Tonight's show is titled, Please Bust My Unions, Black-Robed Priests. As always, remember, those who need to control thoughts need to control news. Until tomorrow at 12:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, this is Paul Gordon of iState.tv saying, have a great rest of your day, fellow iStaters.